Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I welcome you in this social class, student. As we have completed our 14th lesson and we are moving to the 15th lesson, coming of the British. How the British come? That, okay. So European traders followed Magellan and started sailing around the world and to find new lands. India was a rich country where many great kingdoms existed. See, the European traders those who are selling or they are coming to sell their goods, their products, okay. So the twins looked at cousin Rahul expectantly. Expectantly, expectantly means excitedly. They are waiting for the cousin Rahul, who he was going to tell the twins about the European traders who came to India to do business. Traders who came to India to do business and then established their role over the country. Means Rahul is going to say about the European traders that who came to India for business and then they established the rule over the country to the twins. So did the European use the land route to enter India? So what they are saying that they are using a land route, the land area, the way of land, okay. As Millie, looking at the map of the world, I mean through Central Asia and Afghanistan. Okay. Rahul shocked his head. No, the land route was not the only route through which people came to India. Remember how traders like Magellan had started sailing around the seas and discovering sea routes to new places. Magellan sailed from the sea route. So they are saying that not only they have used on only the land routes, they used sea routes also to come to the India and for the say discovered a sea routes to the new places. Okay, now coming to the Vasco da Gama comes to India. See, from very early time, India was famous for spices, pearls, gold and silk. Spices, pearls, gold and silk. In spices like cinnamon, cardamom and cumin seeds. These all are the spices. So, our India was famous for that. Pearls, gold and silk. So, Arab sailors who crossed the Arabian Sea in their ship were the first to trade with India. So, Arab sailors were the first sailors to trade with India. So, in 1498, Vasco da Gama, an explorer from Portugal, discovered a direct sea route from Europe to India by sailing around Africa. So the Portuguese landed at Calicut, now called Kozhikode in Kerala. So these Portuguese, the Vasco da Gama, landed at Calicut in Kerala and started trade in spices. So the Dutch, the English and the French followed and set up their own trading centers. So to control the trade in India and earn more profit, traders soon started fighting among themselves. So to earn the profit, traders themselves started fighting with them. So the East India Company. See, the traders organized themselves by setting up the East India Company. The outside the traders, they have started a East India Company and that company is also known as the British East India Company. And it was established in the year 1600. So slowly the East India Company become very rich by defeating the other traders and controlling much of the traders. Okay, in India. So the Battle of Plassey. The Battle of Plassey was a battle that the East India Company won in 1757. So that victory in the battle cleared the way to for the British to enter in the rule over India. Okay, now we will see about the Battle of Plassey. See, the Mughal Empire, as we have seen in our other lesson, Mughal Empire become very weak after Aurangzeb died in 1707. So this time India Company, East India Company was eager to have, means they are waiting for eagerly where they are waiting to control over various parts of India to further increase the profits in trade. So Bengal, at the time Bengal was a rich state where the East India Company wanted to control that state. So British began taking steps to gain control over that state. So without the permission of Siraj-ud-Daulah, the Nawab, Siraj-ud-Daulah was the Nawab of Bengal at that time. So the East India Company without his permission started to maintain its own army at Calcutta, now called the Kolkata. And the Nawab declared war with the East India Company. But due to his Om General Mir Zafar, he was not cooperated. He supported the British people. So he was defeated at the Battle of Plassey in 1757. Okay. So after few years, in 1764, the East India Company won the Battle of Boxer, with the Bengal was now under control, totally under control with the British. So this was the beginning among the British rule in India. And then the East India Company took advantages of that, because they have taken the advantages of the Indian people, because in that they are having a lack of unity among the Indian rulers, and they can gradually defeat the Dutch, Portuguese and French East India Companies and also the local rulers, and eventually establish total control over the whole country. So students, till here we will stop it. Practice the hard words and practice the hard work, students. Thank you.